I'm Dr. Johnny. Today we're talking under eye filler, the most common area that people ask for filler within a practice. So today, the under eye filler is what people ask most to watch being injected. Let's see, I want to do a tear drop. Let's inject a tear drop. Why is that? It's because it's difficult. It's not the most easiest area to inject, and we have so many products, a lot of people aren't sure which product do we even use under the eye. So we talked about the upper eye and hooded eyes in one of our previous video, but now it's the lower eye, so we'll focus there. It ages many people first, and it's some of the thinnest skin in the body, just like the neck skin. So when people smile, there's often redundant tissue, but then there's also a hollow that develops from the cheek descending down, and then the tear trough or the bag beneath the eye that people describe herniating anteriorly, and that develops a little trough. So what do we do? Mainly, hyaluronic acid fillers are what's used here. My preferred method is using a microcannula technique coming inferior. Now, just by injecting the midface, the cheek region, it's going to make the under eye look better. So this is the first area to address is the ptosis or the falling of that cheek. That'll immediately help most under eyes. But most people who are coming in complaining about an under eye will still need a little bit of filler in that tear trough. And so what we do is use a microcannula, inject below the orbicularis oculus, the muscle that surrounds the eye, so that we don't see the filler. One of the biggest pitfalls is we use hyaluronic acid. What does that do? It draws water in. We need to pick a product that doesn't draw water in. However, there is a caveat. We're all different people and we're all going to draw water in differently. So even though we have a great choice of product, some of them still will draw water in a specific person, and patients need to know this. But filling the area when the skin is good with the microcannula gives a beautiful, pleasing result. And if we want to address the fine lines on the lid, at the lid margin, something like platelet-rich fibrin, also with a microcannula technique, can help tighten the skin around the eye. Choosing our patients is most important. If there's too much herniation of the fat pad below the eye, not everyone is a candidate, and this would be a person that we would choose not to inject. What's the average volume? A lot of people ask this. The average volume would be one vial per side. How do I do it? I like everything in twos, so I like to inject and then re-inject at about 2 months the second vial. So we start with half under each eye, and that gives us a 2 month follow-up to really fine tune it and make and create beauty beneath the eye. So thanks for joining me today. A lot of people have different opinions of the eye and have had their procedure done. We'd love to hear from them in the comments below. Join us on Instagram, Facebook, and of course this YouTube channel for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.